What's going on, guys? It's Nathan with Technology Smash back with another video, and today I have an opening and unboxing of the Moto 360 Sport. So this is the new version Moto 360 that came out for 2015, but this is the Sport model that came out afterwards. So this is made for people who are more active, I guess you would say, or Motorola would say. So the watch is made for people who are doing activities, and you can tell by the material used for the watch itself. If we take a look around on the side of the box here, it says stay fit by tracking speed and distance with GPS, heart rate monitor, any light display for better visibility, messages, notifications, works with Android and iPhone. If you notice near iPhone, there is a single star, and then iPhone has two stars next to it for the asterisks. Let's take a look and see. It looks like that's just for version numbers for the phone itself that you're using. Not a big deal. So it's got that hard plastic box, just like the last one had, if you saw my unboxing for that one. Yeah, it's basically the same thing. So let's get into this. You just have a little peel tab here that goes all the way around the outside. So we just lift up the edge here and just pull. It's literally almost like a piece of tape that just goes all the way around the outside. So we'll just grab this and pull. And we'll have that glare on the top, so let's pull the top off. It's got that hard outer plastic shell. And we'll pull the watch out. It's got this weird clamshell thing, so we'll set that to the side. And we have our normal stuff. So here is the charger, and if you notice, it's a connected charger brick. It's not a USB 2.0, I think it's called, to micro USB, so. Then we have our standard wireless charger that we've come to know from the Moto 360 watches. So it's a little cradle that it sits in wirelessly, which is nice. And the watch itself, so I'm trying to get this out here. Let's see. It's this. Oh, it just falls apart here, like the clamshell I forgot from the last watch. So set that to the side. It's got this foam padding on the inside to keep the watch in that shape. So we'll pull that off. First thoughts on this band, it's very grippy. There's nothing holding that band together. That was just the grip of the band. It is a lint magnet, so let's see the back here. It's got that active anytime display. Please remove sticker on the back. We're gonna leave that on for now. Then you have the front of the display here. The band itself is very thin and catches a ton of lint. You could tell that right off the bat. So let's go ahead and peel this front sticker off. And we got it in a nice peel. All right. Let's go ahead and hold this side button, turn it on. And again, the button for this watch is on the 2 o'clock position, not the 3 o'clock like the first Moto 360 generation. So the second generation has that. Some kind of button or something on the side here. It doesn't press in, so I'm not sure what it is. So let's let this turn on real quick. Grab the paperwork here and see if we can see what that button is. So we have our MotoCare pamphlet, smart whatever pamphlet. Let's see. I think this is actually looks like warranty information for the watch itself. So we'll throw that to the side. Nothing else in there. Must be this one. Yep. Looks like some information. Let's see. I don't see anything about that button, and there is a picture of the actual button up here. Well, if you guys know what it is, go ahead and link down, or not link down, go ahead and leave a comment down below so I can figure out what that is. I'm not really sure. So it has that active display, just like the Moto 360. So we're going to swipe and start. So English, agree to Motorola's privacy policy, yes. Let's start by pairing with your phone. So this one didn't have us charge right away, which is nice. So it's my iPhone 6S. I already have it downloaded. So let's start that process so we can see if it sets up quickly enough so we can at least see the first start screens. I'm not really going to go over any kind of review in this, just kind of tell you how the materials look. Now, once the Bluetooth passcode that is being displayed on the watch, let's go ahead and put that in. Perfect. I'm going to turn the brightness down here a little bit so we can see better. Perfect. All right, so it's paired, so we're good there. And The screen looks okay so far. I mean, it's not, I can't change the brightness and stuff right now, but it doesn't look as vibrant as the regular Moto 360. You still have the flat tire design on the bottom, of course. You have these little ridges on the edges that it gives it a nice little look, but they're not there for any purpose. Obviously, it doesn't turn or anything like that. Overall, it's okay. Here's it next to my Apple Watch, and it's a pretty good size. I like bigger watches, you guys know, so it's a good size watch. The band is very skinny for how big the watch is, though, and you can kind of see. So let's go ahead and put this together, actually, so we can see the grippiness of this band. I know that sounds weird, or if that's even a word, but we're going to see how the grip holds on to that. It's very grippy. So it's not really going to come out. There's no thing holding it in place besides just the grip of the actual band. So, yeah, I don't know for this price. Obviously, this is a materials issue, and there is some extra features in here, I believe, like GPS and stuff like that, which I saw when I ordered the watch. It had some negative reviews about the GPS not being accurate. So hopefully, that's something that will happen in an update. So here we have it fully set up. We can go through the setup, and I've done this a million times, and I'm sure if you've watched any kind of other channels, you've seen it. So we're gonna go ahead and get out of this if it's gonna let us here and cancel the tutorial. Jeez, okay, there we go. Cancel tutorial. All right, so we're gonna get rid of all these notifications popping up. Let's see. All right, so here's the watch here. Again, the screen looks pretty good. It has that active display where it shuts on and off, and it looks like, yeah, the thing is interactive on the front. It opens Moto Body. There's an actual start button like for a workout. So you press it and it does different functions. So that's pretty cool. It has that button press where you can turn it on and off and it will just go to like an ambient mode, or you can cover it with your palm and it will do that. Let's go ahead and turn on this brightness boost and see. It looks okay. I think that's about as bright as it's gonna get. I'm not gonna say any different. I can't compare it to the other Moto 360 because I don't have it with me here. But it does look a little different. I think it might have to do with that daytime or always on display. But yeah, pretty standard for the watch. I mean, you can't take the band off as far as it looks like. It's pretty much connected to the watch. So I don't know if this is worth it for the 300, but I'll let you guys kind of decide that. This was just a quick unboxing. So I appreciate it, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Thanks.